I use Collaborate, which is a synchronous online tool, allowing students to get together in real time, but at a distance. And it offers some very interesting tools. We can, of course, hear each other and see each other through a video feed. We have opportunity to use a whiteboard for presentations, video, external links to the internet. And of course, a text chat field. So it's a very dynamic environment, lots of fun actually, and I would say that my impression in terms of Collaborate is that it's very easy to use, and students kind of intuitively get it, and we can be up and running very, very quickly. So there's not a severe learning curve, and so that's a good thing. I use Collaborate. Both for occasional office hours or weekly office hours, but primarily as a teaching and learning tool, I use Collaborate to offer opportunities for students to vet their work, to have some synchronous discussion around a particular topic, and importantly, to present their work to one another. So again, it's dovetailing with our sense of community that we create in an asynchronous environment with extending that community to a synchronous environment where we get to talk to each other in real time and get to know each other, nuances of voice and even other nonverbal communication behaviors. But I do use it almost exclusively for presentation because we have students who are at a significant distance from campus. And so it's a great tool for that purpose.
I guess this is a tip for beginning teachers that are going to use Collaborate to maybe get used to just the audio at first and then add in the texting conversation, or maybe limit it just to text or something. Just start slow because it can be really overwhelming at times.
I use Collaborate in almost everyone for synchronous kinds of events. I should mention that I'm not married to Collaborate. If there were a better tool for meeting up with students, I'd use it. If I had a class, and I have, where I have about four or five people, I think my new go-to tool is going to be Google Hangouts. I mean, I love seeing everybody on camera at the same time. It gives you that much more visual connection with people, and I really love how that operates. And I'm hoping that Collaborate and other tools will move more in that area. I know they're trying, but really the video, particularly in Collaborate, is one of the weaker elements of it, and very bandwidth intensive, and so it's an issue. But we use all kinds of things like that, and yes, Collaborate's one of them. I like it. I like it. I like the idea that it has a back channel. I've always enjoyed students whispering in class, and I particularly love being able to see what they're whispering about, and it creates more spontaneity. It gives you those more touchstones, new places where you can grab it, you can see what people are talking about behind your back, and you can see what they're talking about that's either related or only tangentially related to what's going on in the class. But you can make use of that. Now, a lot of instructors want uber focus from their students. Like, I want you a mind meld with my entire class the entire time we talk. I don't like that. I don't need that. In fact, I don't thrive in it, and I don't even believe in it, because even if you think you've got a mind meld with a group, I don't think you really do. They're thinking about other stuff anyway. So go ahead and play with ideas and have divided attention. I'm not bothered by divided attention. All I want is attention, and it doesn't have to always be focused on, the oily words I might have.